Hey, it's Samantha with Majestic Unicorn Tutoring, and today is Reading Rescue Thursday. In this video, we're going to talk about vowel sounds, short and long. So let's jump into it. So the first thing I like to do when talking about vowels is one, make sure that my students know what vowels are. So traditionally, the vowels in the English language are A, E, I, O, and U, sometimes Y. I like to focus on these five first. And the way that I tend to teach these is through the sounds with gestures. So we want to get the body involved in learning these different sounds. So A for apple. You're going to pretend like you're eating an apple. Apple. And I actually got this one from a really great video that I'll link in the description box below so you can take a look at it too. E, like egg. It's like a smiling little egg. So it's like, eh. See how your mouth makes a little open smile. I for itch. So it's ih, ih, I, ih. O for awe, like an opera singer, awe, singing out loud. U is like someone asks you a question and you don't know the answer. So you're like, that's you. Ah, eh, ih, ah, and are the five vowel sounds when we're starting out. So that's what you want to work on with kiddos first. You want to make sure they've got those sounds down. You can do it pretty easily by looking at these words here and just going through words and identifying those short vowel sounds. Sometimes I'll even have my students go through and circle the vowels and then tell me what the vowels are first and then read the whole word together. That's a great place to start. Now, if you want to move into long vowel sounds, that's instead of the sound saying its sound, the sound is going to say its name. So for example, A would say A, E would say E, I would say I, O would say O, and U would say U. And the way that I like to teach this is by using Super E. There is another really good video on Super E that I like to show kids, but basically what Super E does is he takes all of his strength and he gives it to the other vowel in the word, and then he's left with nothing else. If we were to put Super E on the word van, it would become vain. So you see how the A is now saying its name, A, vain. So Super E, he can fly over, he can bop this A on the head, give it all of his strength, and then the A says A, a very strong A sound. And then E says nothing on the end because he's lost all of his powers. What about for pet? If we put an E on the end of pet, we have Pete, the name. For bit, we have b, I, you hear the I sound instead of the I sound. For not, instead of it being that aw sound, if I put an E on the end, he can fly over, hit that O and make him say O, which is a very strong vowel sound. And tub with an E on the end says tube. You can hear the U inside the word tube. So that is how I tend to teach short and long vowel sounds. That's how I get things going. And it's really fun because if I'm doing spelling tests with a kid and they, you know, the word is bite and they put B-I-T, I'll say, well, that says bit, but how can I make it say bite? And then usually they're like, oh, Super E. And it gets to be a really fun thing that we get to talk about and notice within our writing. If you love these tips and you want to see more, make sure you hit the subscribe button. We at Majestic Unicorn Tutoring would love to help you with any question you have, be it reading, math, writing, grammar, science, social studies, whatever you'd like. We'd love to help you out with any questions you might have, so go ahead and leave a comment down below so we can get back to you and maybe we'll make a fun little video out of it as well. Remember that getting help is much easier than you think. For any questions, email us at info@majesticunicorntutoring.com. Your first session is always free, and I'll see you next time. Bye!